Asabiri has been assigned to explain about South Asian Association of Regional Cooperation. Okay, let's get started. SAR is the Regional Intergovernmental Organizations and Geopolitical Union of Nations that consists of 8 countries and located in South Asia. It is established in 1985. The headquarters is located in Kathmandu, Nepal, and the official languages of SAR is English. Some key facts about SAR are: SAR comprises 3% of the world's area, 21% of the world's populations, and 3.8% of the global economy as of 2015. The originality members of SAR are India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Nepal, Bhutan, and Sri Lanka. On 2007, the list is updated as they include Afghanistan as the 8 members of SAR. Moving on to the objective of SAR. Firstly, to cooperate with international and regional organizations with similar aims and purposes. Next is to promote the welfare of the people of South Asia and to improve their quality of life. On top of that, the objective of SAR is to contribute to mutual trust that lead to understanding and appreciation of one another's problem. Next is to accelerate economic growth, social progress and cultural development in the region and to provide all individuals the opportunity to live in dignity and to realize their full potential. Next, let us examine the achievement of SAR. SAR has achieved significant success in economic field and has ventured into vital cooperation in the core sector of trade, commerce, finance and money. The most important agreement, SAFTA, has led to abolition of double taxation, free movement of certain commodities across the border and preferential treatment to regional trade than trade outside the region. Next, they contribute a lot in the field of science and technology. Meaningful and constructive exchanges have taken place in the areas which are relevant to South Asian economy. These include solar energy, biofertilizer, low-cost housing, electronics and molecular biology, biomass gasification, recycling of wastewater, and development of technology for pollution control. SAR has also ventured into some controversial areas by signing a convention on terrorism, convention on drug trafficking and drug abuse. These are very serious issues disturbing South Asia. On the contrary, the failure of SAR can be seen as there. SAR could not be able to accomplish its end and targets. This is due to inadequacy of trust and cooperation among the member countries. This can be seen when the conflict between India and Pakistan still remains unresolved. Rivalry between India and Pakistan, the two largest members of SAR, has hovered hugely on SAR. The rivalry continues to restrain SAR from functioning as a sub-regional organization. Next, SAR faced with unresolved border and maritime issue. The region is still beset with many unresolved border and maritime issue. These unresolved borders have led to problems of terrorism, refugee crisis, smuggling and narco trade. The unresolved issue continue to mar cooperative relations. SAR also failed to increase trade between member countries due to low ranking on Human Development Index. The impact of the SAR in the world of the business can be seen as they introduced South Asian Free Trade Agreement, SAFTA. SAFTA came into force in January 1, 2006. This helped the easy access to members' countries' market because a free trade agreement has made it possible boost trade among intra-SAR countries. There is an increasing volume of trade among SAR countries, especially after the SAFTA agreement. In 2005, there was intra-SAR trade of $16.6 billion, while in 2012 it reaches $14 billion, an increase of about 141%. Has SAR delivered? Has it contributed in any way to make the life of billion living in the area better? Has it resulted in greater interaction among the SAR nation? Is it relevant? As we can see that nowadays, trade between South Asian states remains relatively low when compared to other regional blocs. The political and economic ties between states rest on shaky foundation. Division among South Asian countries have made regional cooperation difficult and have led states to pursue their economic goals bilaterally. SAR is still a valuable forum for political dialogue in South Asia, but its economic role in the region has been mitigated by conflict and tension among its member states, such as conflict between India and Pakistan still remain unresolved. This argument supports why SAR is not relevant in today's business context.
Thank you.